Now we're going to be taking a look at Unorthodox, a Netflix limited series inspired by Deborah Feldman's New York Times bestselling memoir of the same name. The series follows Esty, a 19-year-old Hasidic Jewish woman living in Williamsburg, Brooklyn. We see her struggle to conform to her community's expectations and her arranged marriage, but eventually she finds the courage to escape to Berlin and begin a new life. But before long, her past catches up with her. With us today from Tel Aviv is breakout actress Shira Haas, who plays Esty Shapiro, and showrunner and writer Anna Winger from Berlin. But first, we're going to take a look at a clip.
Ms. Shapiro? Mm-hmm. Have you prepared another piece? It would be nice to hear something different.
Okay. Mi ibon siach shoishan choichim ahavas kalu mesois doidim mi ibon siach Shoishan choichim Ahavas kalu mesois doidim Mi bon siach Shoishan choichim Ahavas kalu mesois doidim Mi bon siach shoishan choichim Ahavas kalu mesois doidim Yevurach esechuson v'yeves hakalu son vieves
Wow.
Never gets old.
Wow.
I still get goosebumps every time. It's an insane scene. You know, Shira, I was thinking about everything that went into that scene. I mean, not only is it just the pinnacle of emotion, you know, we've been building through this period of suppression of all Esty's feelings, and then it all just bursts out in this moment. And then we've got her long lost mum is sitting in the audience, her husband who's come to find her, the people in her new Berlin life in the front, and it's just a crossroad. It's an amazing moment. Tell me what went into shooting that, because not only did you not know Yiddish before starting this role, but tell me about the singing. There's just so much.
Wow. First of all, it's been a while since I saw it or listened to it, so I'm a bit emotional now. And I saw Anna now as well watching it, so it's very special. And yes, it was, I think it was alongside the very challenging scenes that we had, it might have been the scene that I was most nervous and excited about. I mean, It's a story about a woman's finding her voice, and in this scene, she's literally finding it, and she's even surprising herself that it came out of her. And it's kind of like her scream or women's scream, I don't know. So it's such a symbolic scene, and I always love singing. And for me, my favorite singers are also the ones that I feel like they have meaning when they sing it. For me, singing is also acting. And in this project specifically, it meant so much, this moment of Esty singing. So, of course, it's a song, but it has a lot of intention to it. And it's also the song from the wedding that we see in the previous episode. So it's kind of like a closure, and it meant a lot for me. I was so nervous in that day. My voice was shaking. And yeah, it was a very special shooting day, definitely.
Anna, so I'm really curious about the process of creating a show that's based on someone's life. Obviously, Deborah's memoir differs from the show in some ways. For example, in real life, I don't think she went to Berlin. What was the process of staying true to her and her story, but making content that would really resonate in a series, a TV series?
Well, we know her personally. She's a friend. She was a friend before. And so there was a lot of back and forth initially about how to bring this to screen and sort of the amount of creative freedom that we would need to kind of break it apart and put it back together differently. I created the show with Alexa Karolinski, who's a filmmaker who lives in Berlin. She lives in LA, but she's from Berlin. We had a lot of ideas of other things about the city that we wanted, and about the sort of layers of experience of being Jewish in Berlin that we wanted to include, sort of layers of history that exist simultaneously that we felt really resonated with the Hasidic experience. But Deborah does live here now. You know, when she left home, she originally didn't, you know, there was a few years in between before she came here, but she does live here now. So I would say that the adaptation process, you know, in a funny way, you have to sort of kill the original in order to create something new. And we did that with her blessing.
Absolutely. I love the whole trajectory of her escape. It's like a thriller at the same time as being a coming of age story. It's amazing. I feel like the series has had an incredible impact across the world. You know, the response to it has been enormous. What do you both feel is the reason for that?
Well, I mean, I guess I generally think that very specific stories can travel in a way that general stories are different. There's something about the specificity of her journey that I think a lot of people relate to. And it's also been really moving for us, the degree to which I think all of us who are involved in making this show, the degree to which it has crossed borders of faith and culture into places that where people don't have any contact at all with this community or even with Jews in general. You know, it's been popular in India and in the Latin American world, Catholic world, Muslim world, Hindu world. So I think that somehow there's something about the specificity of her journey that really, it's crazy the people who relate to it. It's so gorgeous for us.
Yeah. I mean, I totally agree. I think that's also why I really fell in love with this project, even while reading it, because, I mean, I read about, like I always say, about a different character than me, a different culture, so-called. And yes, as a secular woman, girl, I still saw myself within Esty. And I think also, I mean, in the last few months, a story about freedom and about finding yourself, and about making choices, especially in this time that we're living in. I mean, I think it's more relevant than ever, maybe. So I want to believe that's also why people found like escapism or something, or could relate to in Esty's story as well.
Yeah. I think it's transportative in ways that maybe people really struck a chord with people at home.
I also was very struck by the raw emotion that we see from Shira. You know, it's so palpable. And I'd love to hear you talk about the head shaving scene. I know we spoke about this before, but it's day one of shooting, right? Tell us what that was like.
First day of shooting. You do like that. because you don't.
I'm still crying.
Yeah. It was the first student day. It was one heck of a welcome. I knew really from the beginning that it's going to happen, and I was really willing to do it because I believe in this story. So I wasn't really questioning it, not even for a second. And yet, I remember when we arrived to the location, I started to be nervous and I had all these butterflies. And I felt everything, all of these mixed emotions. I was really nervous and scared. I always had like the longest hair as a grown up and as a child, and suddenly losing it. And also excited because it's the first shooting day and I'm doing it for a role that I really believe in. And it's kind of like Esty, I always say, because she's also very excited to get married, to maybe have a new life, hopefully. And she's also scared and has questions. So it worked well together. And yeah, but there was a lot, I mean, there were a lot of Shira also in that scene, in different volumes that I changed, but definitely, yeah.
And Anna, that was obviously a really, I mean, you've created this moment for her to play and she's willing to do it. What was that like for you?
Yeah, no, it was wild. And I still remember sitting by the monitor with Alexa and we were watching and we were crying. And we, I mean, for us, it was just totally overwhelming. And then we looked at each other and said, her head is perfect. Because, you know, there was this insane performance, right? And then we were like, you know, you don't know what's under her beautiful hair, right? And we were like, her head is perfect.
You never know.
Yeah. You never know.
Anna, you know, I love the way you sort of bookend that experience with the moment where Esty's swimming in the lake and she takes off the wig, and it's this liberating moment in a different way where she's liberated from that experience. Tell me about some of the hardest scenes to shoot for you, maybe emotionally and technically.
I didn't find it emotionally difficult to shoot. I thought it was, you know, that's the actors, you know, bring it to life in a way that's actually always exciting for me. But I think that shooting the wedding was very challenging because real Hasidic weddings are very long. And we wanted to make sure to choose the most emotionally significant parts of it. So that was, and it was very hot and, you know, it was from a production standpoint, very complicated. And we had to do many things over and over again with a lot of extras. And so those were very challenging moments. But then there were also just some incredibly transcendent, incredible dance moments. And, you know, even shooting the ritual of when they actually marry under the chuppah. And by the way, we missed just one little piece of it we didn't do because that would have meant they were actually married. So we were very careful with certain specifics of the rituals, but it was just, it was very, that was an incredible thing to see how Maria, our director, and our cinematographer, Wolfgang, how everybody brought that to life. Was just, it was an incredible couple of days, wasn't it? Shira, yeah.
Amazing. Yeah, I'll never forget that dress. Never. In my life.
That was one hot dress.
Really hot as well, right?
Yeah. It was really hot.
That was amazing. Those scenes were amazing. So Shira, I'd like to know what you learned from Esty and what you hope other people will learn from her.
Wow. Yeah, I mean, I've learned so much from this project as an actress in general and from the amazing people that I've met, and also from the character, from Esty. I think even while reading it and while just starting to perform the character, it's always been about like the value of freedom. I always felt like that is something that always occurred to me, that she comes, this character Esty, comes from such a difficult circumstances, and she didn't give up, and she kept asking herself, what do I want? What freedom is for me? And sometimes I ask myself if I ask it enough. You know, I don't come from the same circumstances, of course, but I think freedom is really kind of like your ability to choose and to make choices and to see clear what's right for you. So it made me question it a lot, and hopefully it helped me to keep asking it and to get it and also to appreciate the fact that I have it, and that's a lot. And I want to believe that other people achieve that from this character and the story in general as well.
Well, I want to thank you both so much for being here to talk about this amazing series. It was just so wonderful and such a privilege to talk to you both. Congratulations on both your Emmy nominations. So well deserved.